While working on a drawing, it's only natural that we may need to change the position of several objects we have created or inserted. For example, in the open drawing, we see a single room's floor plan along with a few items. However, those items are in a random place outside the room, so I need to rearrange them. To do that, I will use the Move tool to place them inside the room. However, since I do not intend to move them in random places, I have to be careful to place each one of them in the correct position. For this reason, I will need to activate the appropriate 2D object snaps before I define where the items will be moved. For this exercise, I will need the endpoint snap as well as the midpoint snap active, so I will open the snaps list and make sure they are both checked. To activate the command, I can either open the Modify menu or click on the Move icon, which I can find in the Modify panel of the Home ribbon. Once the tool is active, a message prompts me to select the objects I wish to move. I will select the kitchenette and press Enter. Next, I need to specify the base point, namely the point which I will move the object from. Since I want the left upper corner of the kitchenette to coincide with the internal left corner of the wall, I will specify the base point in the left upper corner of the kitchenette. Lastly, I need to specify the point which I will move the object to. This point must coincide with the base point I previously specified. So in this case, I will click on the internal left upper corner of the wall. As you can see, the kitchenette is now in the right place and the command has deactivated automatically. Next, I will place the countertop next to the kitchenette. I will activate the command again, select the object, and press Enter. Again, I need to specify the base point, so I have to think what point I need to move the object from. I am going to click on the upper right corner of the rectangular item, and once the endpoint appears, I will click on the internal right upper corner of the wall. At last, I will move the sink in the middle of the countertop. So I will activate the Move tool once more, select the sink, and press Enter. This time, however, I will set the base point in the middle of the upper side of the sink, and move this point to the middle point of the upper side of the countertop. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that I can move an object a certain distance from its original position. To give you an example, I will move the dining table along with the chairs a little more to the left to increase the distance between the table and the window. As you can see, this distance is currently 0.2 meters. So this time, I will select all the objects I want to move, and then I will right-click on them. From the menu that appears, I will select Move. This is another way to activate the Move command. I will click on the midpoint of the side of the table to specify the base point and activate the Ortho mode to restrict my cursor orthogonally. Then, I will move the cursor to define the direction and type the number 0.5 to define the distance. Once I press Enter, the objects have moved 0.5 meters to the left.